Hello, my name is Vanessa. I'm a food technician in LegaleGo Food Consultancy. And in this video, I'm going to talk about what the labeling of food supplements should be. First of all, there is a general regulation on food information provided to the consumer. This is the regulation 1169 from 2011. But in addition to this regulation, we have to take into account the internal regulation of each single country where the product will be sold. For example, in France, there are mandatory warnings for vitamins and minerals that are not mandatory in other European countries, such as Italy, Spain, or Germany. Or for example, in Italy, the mandatory warning of keep out of reach of young children should be indicated as keep out of reach of children under 3 years old. With this, I mean that they are not literal translation, and as we have commented, we have to take into account the internal regulation of each single country. But broadly speaking, the mandatory point that we have to take into account in a food supplement label are the name of the product, the denomination of the product, that it is a sentence containing the category of the product, in this case food supplement, with the active ingredients that the product contains. Also, we have to add the net quantity. It must be in the same visual area as the denomination of the product. Other points are the recommended daily dose, the direction, that is how the product is to be taken. For example, take one tablet per day before going to bed. Another important point is the list of ingredients. We have to add all the active and non-active ingredients in decreasing order of weight. Also, a very important point is the nutritional information table of active ingredients per recommended daily dose, the warnings, the storage conditions, the batch number, the expiry date sentences, and also the distributor, that is the company which is going to notify the product in each single country. There is another point that is not mandatory, but it is very important. They are the health claims. They must be accepted by the law, either through the regulation 2432 or be on hold by the EFSA. But this point will be explained by my colleagues in another video. I hope you found this information useful, and in case you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us.